Hey guys, I am moving from Charlotte, North Carolina to Phoenix, Arizona. I'm actually standing here in my pretty empty apartment, just got a couple more things to get. I am driving myself and all my stuff in my car, but luckily I had already sold most of my big stuff anyway, so really it was just my essential items, my clothes, my kitchen stuff, my bathroom stuff, and just a couple big things like my guitars. Those are definitely essential to me. I did pack up last night so that this morning I could just go ahead and go. And while I was packing, it started storming and I just got really wet, but it was all right. That being said, obviously before you take such a long road trip, it's gonna be about 2,000 miles. You definitely need to make sure that your car is in good shape. I have spent quite a bit of money in the past couple months making sure everything was fixed. And just the other day, I actually spent most of my day off working on something myself just to make sure I didn't shell out $400 or $500 all at once. And you know, it took a while, but I guess it was worth it. But yeah, you know, if you're watching this and maybe you've been thinking about making a big move too, maybe this will be a little bit of an inspiration for you, because I'm really doing this on a whim. I mean, I have a job set up, I've figured my stuff out, I know where I'm going, but I'm just kind of doing it. So let's see how it goes. Originally, I was going from Mobile, Alabama. I was gonna go through Texas, through Houston, San Antonio, over to El Paso. And yeah, it's so snowy there that I have to reroute. I did not realize it was gonna be so bad down there, but there's, you know, 6 inches of snow on the highways. That's a no-go for me. So now I'm heading back up north towards Little Rock, Arkansas. I'm gonna go from there. I'm trying to be more optimistic about things like this that happen in life. I was in Yazoo City, Mississippi, and I realized I wasn't going to be able to make it much further because it was getting dark. So I'm downtown and I pull down a road that is very icy, and I try to turn around because I realize it's not going to go anywhere and my car gets stuck. So I had to go find a place that had service. I called AAA, they're sending someone to tow me, and they're sending cops to stand with me while I wait. I'm just going back to my car now to get a coat and gloves. So AAA did come, but we weren't able to go to a hotel because they were all booked. So the guy's actually letting me stay at his place. So gotta take what I can get, staying here for the night in Yazoo, Mississippi. So I didn't get to explain it well last night. What had happened was I was in Yazoo City and I saw the roads were getting bad. So I tried to stop there, but all the hotels were booked. So my only option really was to either keep going or go back to Jackson, Mississippi. And Jackson, all those hotels are booked too. So I decided I just needed to keep going. So I tried to go and I hit a bridge that was too icy to cross. It was completely iced over. So I had to turn around and go back into Yazoo. And then I get back into Yazoo and I get stuck in the ice. So I have to call AAA. After calling AAA, an SUV of guys come up behind me and ask if I need help. I say yes, and they push me out. AAA still shows up and I explain the situation to them. And I tell them that I needed to get back to Jackson at least, but everything's booked. And the guy tells me, he's like, man, I can't leave you stranded out here like this. He's like, you can come stay at my place if you want, which was better than dying in my car, freezing overnight. So I told him, yeah, I followed him to his place and I spent the night there. They didn't have power, but they had a heater in the living room. And it worked out. I'm back on my way this morning. So I finally made it to Little Rock, Arkansas. I'm here right now. This is what it looks like. But the interstates are clear. Just little side roads are not, and it's okay. Coming out of Mississippi was the most terrifying drive of my life. There was almost 80 miles of a highway I had to take to get to the interstate that was unplowed. So lots of snow, lots of ice for 80 miles. I did freak out and I did cry in my car on the way up here just because I didn't think I would be able to get through it. But I'm in Little Rock and off to Amarillo tomorrow. I'm leaving Little Rock, Arkansas this morning. I just wanted to make sure the sun was out, start hitting these ice patches because you can see here in the shade, it's still frozen there, but then where the sun hits, it's just water, so it'll be safe. The only thing is just getting out of this road that I'm down right now because it's at the end of a cul-de-sac, and I just gotta go all the way up there. So once I get past this, it's clear roads, clear interstates from here on out, hopefully. So after leaving Little Rock, the roads were great. I made it to Oklahoma City, stopped, got gas, took a chance to get out, stretch, have some food. Now I'm on my way to Amarillo. I'm 3.5 hours away now. That's where I'm gonna stop for the night. The future, yeah, it stays true. Last night I made it all the way to Amarillo, Texas. Right before I got here though, I got pulled over because my headlight was out, which I thought it was because I could barely see. So, I mean, I got this warning here, but that's no big deal. Nothing too serious. Ended up staying in a place just south of Amarillo called Canyon. And I stayed with this guy named Devin, who was very, very cool. And I really hope I can see him again one day. But for now, I'm gonna go to the store, get a new headlight, switch it out, then be on my way to Albuquerque. Leaving Albuquerque this morning. This is my last drive until I get to my new home. It's definitely a great find, finding this Airbnb here, because the couple that hosted me, actually, they're in the film industry. And I was able to talk for hours this morning over a cup of coffee about the industry and how I love to edit. And I got some contacts, definitely some people that I'm going to keep in touch with and see what can happen when I get out there. Because now I have contacts here, and I'm going to try to get some contacts where I'm going. So let's just keep it going, see how it goes.